Woo! Let's see. We are ready for our speak-off, except we just need to do some presentation work. Tighten it up. Good grief. We are getting crunked up in here. We are ready to go kick some ass tonight. Also, I feel a powerful sneeze coming on. I knew it was in there. All right, let's work on our whatever thing. A presentation. Also, I have to convert some stuff to note cards, apparently. Apparently, we can't have the presentation memorized. We have to have it understood, but like ready to be delivered or whatever. Way too early. Dude, they got through it anyways. God damn it. Okay, we can't be stupid distracted with this fucking game. We actually have to work on our presentation. We really, 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 really do. Okay. We're gonna win this fucking money. What are we showing in Streamlabs anyways? I'll brighten up that camera a little bit, or the light. Cause goddamn. Also we need to have a little bit more white light instead. God damn it, do I have a pencil here? Please tell me I have a pencil here. Good deck of cards. Yeah, damn it, I gotta go get a pencil now. Shit! Stay humble. Stop him. Okay, let's get this piece of crap tightened up, locked down. Hell yeah. Stay humble, blessed. Alright. What the fuck are we doing? Other than playing this fucking game. God damn it, that's what I get for not paying attention. Isn't that what I get for not paying attention? Shit. Whatever, it's working now. Thank you.
What next? What's up?
Hey, what's good?
Moab.
What is good, Sir Spanks? A lot.
Stop them.
Oh shit, I died. That's what I get for paying attention.
With enough fuel and air, everything burns.
Dynasties and dystopias. What is good, Sir Spanks a lot? Can you hear me? Can you not hear me? Let me see my microphone. Yeah, it looks like it's hidden. Gee, I should just let it play my music. Say fuck it. Yeah, I don't care if I get I don't care if I get the strike today. So what, they take down my video. Polo to the float up. You already know though. It's Adamville for real. You see your hoes just take a photo. I'm prepping that some photo with a fofo on your brodo. Cause that Jodo thought that he could rob a player for some dodo. Oh no, also Allen Temple. Also England Manor. Also Misty Valley. And I got a couple pounds yesterday out of Cali. And my bad bitch from the valley bought me brand new balance. And I'm playing with a no American dream. Man, she been ride clean since her daddy brought on bowl. I done fucked up in every hole, telling every hole. I ain't fucked up with my wife, but if she meet her, might be a go. Big flat, flashy. Bitch, don't I look dashy. Bitch, don't I look classy. Bitch, don't act so sassy. I'm the man, boo. Dash with her without you. The hell with what your mouth say. Show me what that mouth do. Mouth. What happened? You pass out? Oh, you said you weren't feeling well earlier, actually. How you feeling? Well, I don't know if you're there or not. If you're there, which I hope you are. Hopefully everything's going all right for you. Hopefully you're feeling better. Hopefully your kid's okay. But my presentation is in 4 hours. Technically less than 4 hours. Being like clocks in the wintertime, we stay eating like a dinner time. Been feasting and cheaping and blowing big, but it ain't no reaper rhyme. We don't know the meaning of drought, cause we keep it so wet, why sweat nights? Been a while. Just speaking in general, why there is no formidable opponent or air nigga that bone that. Hit uncut, never step on it. Line for line, dope when you wanna hit, you wanna mind the kind of give a nigga hope when they down and out. Nigga dig a hole so deep, ain't no climbing out. Yeah, I hear him talking hella reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but it's the best shit ever. Hey, don't you see me out here shining? Bitch, I'm better flex. I hear him talking hella reckless. I won't even stress. Just kill him softly with my press. Won't even address. They say lonely at the top, but it's the best shit ever. And even if we die today, this shit gon' live forever. Live forever.
I got some cocoa, my vision is pimp. You already know though, no, so go ho, slow ho, for the popo, that my logo, for show ho, go, get down on the flow, yo ho, listen, just like I told Coco, my vision is pimp. You already know though, no, so go ho, slow ho, for the popo, that my logo.
plot and scheme. Mario C likes to keep it clean. Wanna shine like Gaso theme. Beam. Fun rapping, cause that's my dream. Change Monty for sticking to me.
You will agree. Ain't no brother like the K-I-D-D. You know what I mean? Telling you with the echo? Telling you.
As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I take a look at my life and realize there's nothing left. Cause I've been blasting and laughing so long that even my mama thinks that my mind is gone. But I ain't never crossed a man that didn't deserve it. Me be treated like a punk, you know that's a hater. You better watch how you're talking and where you're walking. Or you and your homies might be lying in chalk. I really hate the trip, but I gotta know. As they croak, I see myself in the pistol smoke. Fool, I'm the kind of G your little homies wanna be like. On my knees in the night, saying prayers in the street light.
We've spent most our lives looking the gangsters pass.
Situation they got me facing. I can't live a normal life. I was raised by the street, so I gotta be there with the hood team.
Too much television, watch me, got me chasing dreams.
I'm an educated fool with money on my mind. Got my tin in my hand and a gleam in my eye. I'm a low-down gangster, set tripping banker. And my homies is down, so don't arouse my anger. Fool, death ain't nothing but a heartbeat. The way I'm living life, do or die. What can I say? I'm 23 now, but will I live to see 24? The way things are going, I don't know. But nobody's here to teach me. If they can't understand it, how can they teach me?
guess they can't, I guess they won't, I guess they front. That's why I know my life is out of luck, fool.
Pay enough attention just to get fucking past the stage. My slides.
Thank you.
appears that they're not going to let me walk around, though, during this presentation. I like walking and talking. I am so good at walking and talking, it's ridiculous. And they keep me confined to this chair. They keep me confined to a podium. It will not work so well. Also, goddamn, I look like I've probably gotten a fight with, like, a raccoon that's been punched in the eyes. Right, man. Okay. It actually didn't. I thought that happened a few times, I guess. I'm assuming it didn't. I don't know. I hope it didn't. I was trying. Shit. Subs. RYBGT777. Well, thanks for the follow. Sorry, I'm doing some homework now. Just listening to some music. Can you play with? Sure, if you don't mind the fact that I'm doing homework. Like, I'm only like half paying attention is the problem. But yeah, you can play with me. I don't care. Put your friend code in chat. Hit me up with the match code. Either way. I was kind of casually playing though, just so you know. But I just went through. Yeah, that's fine, I don't care. Yeah, just hit me up with the code. Get it, you play whatever match you want. But again, just now I'm working on my note cards. Hey Sparrow, just working on note cards, working on homework. Map you want, whatever orientation you want, I don't care. Doesn't matter to me. You really want to do easy though? Easy? Alright. Do yourself. Not here to stop yet. Beastmaster, eh? That's fine. Let's see, she didn't mention anything about. No, I don't. She didn't. I'm at 5 already, and I'm not, like. Like, I'm trying to, like, keep it kind of bullet pointed, but I'm also kind of running out my full speech, I guess? I don't know. I'm trying to like super abbreviate it to just the bullet points, and then like I think one thing I think that you should keep in mind, Sparrow, is I think since we have 2 rounds, I think they're gonna do 1 preliminary round, and then for the 2nd round they're gonna see how much we deviated from the speech to know if we just memorized it or not. You know what I'm talking about? Picking up what I'm putting down? following me, following what I'm saying. This is my guess on what they're gonna do. Not really, but I don't particularly care what this is, as long as it isn't first. Jesus Christ. Chill out. How'd you get first? That way you have to eat in front of people. Beat your ass anyways. Cause I came to throw down. I'm not gonna go easy on ya. Hero Academy song even just came on. What is this? You say run? Okay. Yeah, you say run. It's on. Is this really what you wanted to do? Was just easy? They decided to use a farmer on an easy standard game. But hey, that's okay. Not like I have to do anything. I love it. Keep carrying me to victory. Oh, don't worry, I'm not going easy on you. I don't have an easy bone in my body. You're all hard. Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy. Lose them? No, they left the game. I guess they're weird. Okay. Oh. Why do you need cash, dude? The game's almost over. You would set it to easy. Yeah, like we're done. You didn't need cash. Ah, we can go to free play. What are you going for, 100, 200? China fiscal budget. Side Sparrow, you know exactly how good my speech already is. You should be intimidated. No? Did you respond to it? Go ahead, let's hear it. You think I'm gonna put people to sleep? Is that what you're gonna say? Yeah, that's on you. It's not my fault you don't understand the intricacies of foreign politics and economy. Based U.S. politics. Politics are based. I guess I'm only gonna have 8 cards. That's not so bad. But I need to touch up my PowerPoint. Debt security is, but I'm not gonna stay. I'm gonna end up 9 cards actually. Huh, that's probably a good sign, right? That we both have 9 cards. Cut it down to 8, 1 card technically. Yeah, this is like my final sentence. It's also going to be that. It's like the last sentence of the thing. Technically it's like a paragraph when I wrote it in the speech, but like I'm abbreviating it down, so it's gonna be a sentence. I could probably press it into one of these cards if I really like rewrote all these cards. But I think 9 cards is, I don't know. See, I still feel like mine has more of a tendency towards a persuasive speech than a informative, but... Bam! 9 cards. Last thing I need to do now is just say, I'm gonna write on the card, like in the corner, when I should swap slides. That's the last thing I'm gonna do. you sell them all? You are wilding out. I'm actually kind of legitimately surprised that you sold all those. I don't know why you're still the banks now at this point. Hell yeah, because that's a good idea. Look, I want a strong opponent. Strong opponent. Question is, how do I want to update my station?
I want a girl with a smooth liquidation. I want a girl with good dividends. At Citibank, we will meet accidentally. We'll start to talk when she borrows my pen. She wants a car.
Maybe I should split up the fiscal budget part. If I put the fiscal budget on another slide,
we
Game, man. I don't know why you sold your banana factories. And Bridge to Delts. Have a good day. I don't think you should put a suit jacket in a washer. Did you put it in a washer? Oh, okay. I was gonna say. I got scared for a second. I just, yeah, I got scared. My slides feel like one's out of place. Maybe I accidentally moved them? Mr. Gamertech, in a minute. Hope you're doing well. Sorry, I'm doing homework. I'm a teleboring. Kind of playing a casual game that I can like just do stupid shit on, not worry about, you know. How are you doing? How has school been? Oh, this is the new laptop, eh? Let's see it. MSI, good brand. GE series, all right. GeForce 38 Ti, yeah, okay. What am I looking at here? Is that 16 gigs on the VRAM or is that 16 gigs on the RAM? 16 gig RAM. Ooh, that's probably okay for laptop. Oh, and the GPU has 16 gigs VRAM. Ooh, shit. Yeah, this one seems pretty legit. I'm gonna see if I can put a whole auditorium of people to sleep. I hated public speaking and had to do it numerous times. Once had a room of 80 people I had to speak to about economics and history. Fuck yeah, that's my subject. I am literally about to go talk to them about the US economy, US debt, and China, and why it's leading to peace. And I'm probably gonna do it. I don't know how many people are gonna be at this thing. Sparrow, how many people do you think are gonna be at? There might be, but it's not like a negative thing. It's not like, oh hey, these people are bad or anything like that. It's not like that at all. What it's about is like how the debt between our countries actually prevents us from going to war. So the US should actually be very happy that China buys our debt, because it lets us know that China doesn't want to actually go to war with us anytime soon. It's also beneficial to China. They get the payments, they get like a beneficial economic system that lets them trade currencies better.
Oh.
let's see how many people attended this week. Did you know they are fixing the internet, right? With the whole brick cap crap going on.
Brick crap going on.
Brick? Did you spell that right? B-R-I-C-C? Powered by BTARC, Basic Research Innovation Collaboration. Somehow I don't think you mean that. And I don't think you mean these burly ladies that are also showing up, so... You mean BRICC? Like, BRICC. Like, Basic Research Innovation Collaboration Center? Or do you mean the Belt and Roads Initiative? BRI. Is that what you mean? Belt and Roads Initiative, Communist China? Is that what you mean by that? I'm assuming you mean BRI, Belt and Roads Initiative, and then maybe Communist China. Belt and Roads Initiative. CC. Country. Is that what you mean? I don't know. Man, I don't know what you mean. I want to know, though. I want to know what you mean. I want to understand. I want to get in your world, okay? No, it's between Russia, China, South Africa, and Saudi Arabia. Look it up on YouTube. I can supply a link. Yeah, if you want to hit me up with a link, I'll look at it, but... B-R-I-C-C. Rick Baby admits to trying cocaine once. Somehow I don't think that's it. Okay, so Russia, China. China, Russia, South Africa, Saudi Arabia. BRICC? BRICS? Brazil, Russia, India. Brazil, Russia, India, China. South Africa, so yes. More investment strategies, you can get potential further expansion, development, blah, blah, blah. To discuss global recession, 2009. Vladimir Putin remains uncertain after the International Criminal Court has issued an arrest warrant. With you, and so you thought you'd just drop by and you expect me to be free, but now I'm saving all my loving for someone who's loving me. Oh, now go walk out the door, just turn around. Now you're not welcome anymore. Okay, yeah, so they're just trying to create an alternate to Swift. Yeah, that's fine. I don't think that has any problem with what everything I'm saying. Yep.
The United States is about to launch a massive military offensive against Russia in the Russian territory, according to reports this morning.
Okay, I know this is probably doesn't mean anything to you. But they spell President Xi Jinping wrong. Like in their own video description. I want to just get that out there immediately. They can't even spell the guy's name right.
We'll get to that in a moment. We'll get to the latest U.S. and NATO attack against Russia.
Because it's J.
Russia and China just took major steps yesterday in
this
reordering.
Way. They didn't even spell it right in their own video description. Just putting that out there initially. That's my first initial.
You're literally taking the world off of a U.S. reserve currency, and you're shifting the entire power dynamic to Russia and China and BRICS nations. That is a new world order, and you're watching it unfold right before our eyes. This is a moment in history we'll be able to tell our children about, the decline of U.S. hegemony, the rise of what we're seeing right now.
I'm going to double check.
So, yeah, we had
Xi Jinping. I'm going to spell it their way.
Of course, with their big meetings over the past few days.
Yep. They didn't even spell his name right.
Early this morning as Xi Jinping was flying out.
I'm just saying, they didn't even spell this guy's name right.
They signed
I question their research. Framework. If that makes sense.
Use Chinese currency.
If they can't even get the guy's name right. You know what I mean? Does that make... You see what I'm getting at? Now, I'm not saying that it's wrong or right. I'm just saying that's a red flag for me immediately. That they can't even get the president of China's name right in their own... Well, I can hold that to them. I could not spell it either. Okay, fair enough. Yeah. Hey, my teacher couldn't spell it either. I had to correct her on it too. She put an extra G in there. So it's X-I-J-I-N. She put a G... Jinping. But I think we should hold that against them, you and I, Mr. Gamertech, because they're reporting news. So they're putting themselves in the position of being a reputable news source or commentating. They should probably get some of their information correct. That doesn't mean it's wrong. They could be entirely right about everything else that they say in this. I'm not saying it's wrong or right. I don't even know yet.
To settle.
That's just initial.
Instead of
initially
US
what
dollar.
I see.
Think about that for a minute. They're going to be using the Chinese yuan to settle trades instead of using US currency.
Now, not only does that account for a large part of the global population because of the size of China and Russia, but they are also encouraging, and President Putin is encouraging other nations to do the same in Africa, in South America. In Latin America, where else? He mentioned three different places. And so those places that are suffering from Western sanctions.
Also, in July, the Fed is launching their own
that,
digital currency
are, say,
to start
Argentina,
weighing out paper
and you
money.
Would like to, you know, continue to finish your nuclear reactors in order to get affordable energy to your people.
I don't,
but
that doesn't
you
even
are
make
suffering
sense.
From Western sanctions, and the West continues to lean on you to sanction Russia, you can say, okay, I don't need to deal with this then. I have
a digital payment
now.
System,
right.
Not a digital currency.
Right, is the options for them, and regardless of how
it's
you
not a digital currency,
it,
it's a digital
a
payment
major,
system.
Major story that the West is completely downplaying. They're much more concerned about Trump being arrested than anything else. They don't even want you to know the decline of the U.S. economy right now and the banking crisis. Like all the headlines are about storms in California, which they're big, and Trump being arrested. But never
no,
mind.
No,
What's
they're not weeding out paper
with this
money. They're not doing that.
Disaster
it's a,
and the multipolar
hold on, pause
rise
this.
That we're seeing. Going now, Putin and Xi.
No, so, okay. So, like, this is per CNBC. They're starting a... Oh, God damn it. Fucking stupid ass. No, I'm going to leave my ad block on, thank you. Yes, but it is fall into that. There is a county already done it. But it is fall into that. There... Okay, so all this is a digital payment system. So if you're doing a bill pay, if you're paying your bills, right now you have to go through banks. You have to go through Visa or MasterCard or something like that. So this is actually really good because presumably, as long as all your transactions are legal, I think this would be really good, personally. As long as all your transactions are legal, because, there's a really good argument of, like, a lot of pornography was kicked off of, like, Pornhub and X-Hamster and all those porn sites. And it was at the behest of Visa and MasterCard. And it gets kind of scary if banks and these companies are telling us what we can and cannot put on our sites. You know what I mean? Not to say, like, they wanted age verification, which is fine. I just don't think the banks should be the ones regulating what you can and cannot put on your website necessarily. I think they should only be there to facilitate the transfer of currency. That's all they should be doing. So arguably they kind of overstepped their bounds a bit when they did that. It'd be the same thing for like Twitter, you know, like we, like a bank shouldn't be able to shut off, like, you know, Elon Musk's stuff because they didn't like something Elon Musk said or something. So all this is just a digital payment system. Now, presumably, as long as it's all legal, like everything you're doing, you're not like buying drugs. Like, not good, my friend, not good at all. The digital payment system will lead to the nullification of paper money as it did in the other country. No, this is just a bill payment system, though. I don't see how that would make the money transfers such as paychecks and disbursements from the government, as well as a host of other consumer activities, to move more rapidly and lower costs, according to the Power Program's goals. Participants will complete a training and certification, blah, blah, blah. We'll launch drawing near. We urge financial institutions and their industry partners to move full steam ahead with preparations to join the Fed now. No, I don't think this is going to replace paper money at all. I highly doubt that. Now, it could. Some Fed officials say the program even could supplant the need for a central bank digital currency. While the Federal Reserve has made no decisions on whether to pursue or implement a central bank digital currency, or CBDC, we have been exploring the potential benefits and risks of CBDCs from a variety of angles, including through technological research and experimentation. Our key focus is on federalreserve.gov. Our key focus on whether and how a CBDC would improve on an already safe and efficient U.S. domestic payment system. It's only for domestic payment system. That doesn't mean anything about them doing away with currency. I don't think the two are equivalent. Let's see here. Yes, that is how it starts. They are wanting to get rid of bank. Well, I'm going to avoid this rabbit hole and go practice my speech. A choice, Sparrow. No, I don't think this is going to get anywhere near getting rid of a physical currency. Today in the United States, Federal Reserve notes, i.e. physical currency, are the only type of central bank money available to the general public. Like existing forms of money, a CBDC would enable the general public to make digital payments as a liability of the Federal Reserve. However, a CBDC would be the safest digital asset available to the general public with no associated credit or liquidity risk. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. I don't know if this is necessarily gonna. I don't see this getting rid of a paper currency. You said another country, digital payment leads to digital currency. Because the only place that I think could even remotely try and do that is either China, North Korea. Although North Korea doesn't have the electrical infrastructure for it. China or Japan. Maybe South Korea. I could see South Korea. New era of digital money. Digital forms of money can be a boon, blah, blah, blah. Emerging markets lead the way. Maintaining a balance. Global approach. Yeah, I don't care about this. Like, what is... Central bank digital currency tracker. Central bank digital currencies. What is central bank digital currencies? CBDC. Yeah, if you have something on a country switching over to that, I'd be very, very interested to read that. Which country switched to... Oh, hold on, wait. Some countries, including China, India, Nigeria, and Bahamas, have already rolled out digital currencies. Doesn't exactly roll off the tongue, but you might want to get used to saying it. The so-called blah, blah, blah. I am not going to subscribe. God damn it. Okay, hold on. I will get you the link. It's freaking bad. I don't personally think that this is going to end up in the result of like physical currencies going bye-bye. I don't foresee that. There are times where you need a physical currency, like if you're doing transactions. One, if you're trying to do private transactions. Two, if you're trying to do transactions in a place where you don't have cellular or digital networks. Plus the implementation of, like, if the government's going to do this and say that all currency's gone, let's just say hypothetically they take away all physical currency, all physical currency is gone, it's all digital, it's all tracked based on what they say, well then it's all, they have to provide some kind of infrastructure where no matter where you are, if you're in the boonies of Louisiana, that you can do a transfer of assets to pick up whatever item you're trying to buy or whatever. You'll see, I hate that it will come to that, but it will. Dude, I used to listen to Glenn Beck. I'm not even like, I'm not even criticizing you. This is not gonna happen. I mean, they're gonna make a digital payment system. And we can look at maybe if they have a digital currency, but that's not going to replace or supplant physical dollars. I don't see any evidence showing that. Now it says China and Nigeria, which I don't even know how like much Nigeria can maintain a digital currency, but like I highly doubt. I would put this at a 99% certainty that it's not going to replace it.
They're going to build a massive new border infrastructure. So among the 14 agreements, a new border infrastructure, which expands agricultural cooperation, they'll be improving.
Also, like, not gonna lie, I mean, this guy says he's former Fox News. The only person I really like from Fox News, you're gonna hate, Shepard Smith.
The cooperation of exchanging energy, minerals, metals, chemicals. Well, I mean, what else is on there on the list?
Things that they actually mine,
right,
and control. We've done reports here about how the United States does have a lot of these resources, but environmental groups are stopping the mining of those things. And so if you want your nice electronics and smart cars and EVs, you're not going to be able to get them from American manufacturing.
Well, the problem is, okay, so I don't like what they're saying here. They're implying that you can't get access to these things through American manufacturing because the government's withholding it, but that's not the case. The problem is businesses moved overseas because it's cheaper, because China's cheaper. You know, there are some places in Africa that they're trying to build infrastructure on. The problem is stability of their government and their nation. Like, you have to have a it's one good thing about big business is that big businesses are incentivized to try and make sure that these places stay stable, because if these places aren't stable, then all that investment in making these factories and everything just goes out the fucking window. But they're kind of implying here that it's like the U.S. government, but it's not. That's the...
What else is on there on the list, for crying out loud?
Right? Things that they actually mine,
right,
and control. We've done reports here about how the United States does have a lot of these resources, but environmental groups are stopping the mining of those things. And so if you want your nice electronic...
Okay, to be fair, that's not actually what they said. They said a little different.
Of exchanging energy, minerals, metals, chemicals. Well, I mean, what else is on there on the list, for crying out loud? Right?
Things that they actually mine,
right,
and control. We've done reports here about how the United States does have a lot of these resources, but...
Okay, yeah. They said the United States... I'm sorry. So when they said the United States, I thought they were talking about the government, but they're talking about just us as a nation. We have a lot of resources. Yeah, that's probably fair. I don't think necessarily that environmentalist groups are what's stopping that.
Environmental groups are stopping the mining of those things, and so...
I think the problem is other countries want to sell it cheaper, and we want to buy it as cheap as we can. Because I looked up... Lithium? No. Lithium? Cobalt. I looked up cobalt and like what other countries like produce it at, sell it at, all that stuff. And I mean, that stuff's wild, but
if you want your nice electronics and smart cars.
So that's my fault. I did misinterpret what she was saying.
Cars.
Glad I went back.
And EVs, you're not going to be able to get them from American manufacturing.
We don't do any uranium mining in the United States. We have one uranium mine in the United States. One. How did that happen?
What demand is there for uranium? Uranium. What do you call these? Commodity. machine charts? No, hold on. What is this site? Oh, it's the same. I would like to find the same one I got for cobalt. Commodity price. Is it Y charts? No. God, there was this really, really good investing.com, maybe? Fuck, it had like so. It had like all these really great charts that showed a lot of really great information. Cobalt trade. I know they had other stuff, because you could like, where does cobalt even come from? Hold on, cobalt is mined in some place in like South Africa, Congo. Okay, Congo. Congo trade imports, exports. Something cycle, no, it's not the Encyclopedia Britannica. What is it? So many fucking good charts. Cobalt trade imports and exports. Because my friend kept like doing bleeding heart bullshit of like, hey, the U.S. is like causing all this turmoil because of the Congo. It's like, well, no, the U.S. isn't even buying this cobalt from Congo. That's going to like China. Which, granted, it's going into iPhones and shit, which is, or, well, specifically batteries, which is then being repackaged, sent elsewhere, and then here's what's going to happen within the next year. Just my prediction. Russia, China, South Africa, and Saudi Arabia. Okay, again, it's BRICS, but that's okay. Once they start, hold on, wait, oh. It's B, fuck, what is B? Brazil. Russia. I is India. C is China. And then S for Saudi Arabia. BRICS. I'm not saying what you're saying is wrong. I'm just, that's what it stands for. That's what that acronym stands for, is BRICS. Let's see, hold on. Let me minimize this so I can go back to reading what you were saying, though. Here's what's going to happen with it. Just my prediction, Russia, China, South Africa, Saudi Arabia, once they start getting away from the US dollar, our economy will decline so bad and weaken. China will attack Taiwan and destroy it. Either Russia or China will become the new superpower of the world. Russia's not going to become a superpower any world. Russia's not going to become a superpower anytime soon. Russia's losing a war against Ukraine. That's like something that we couldn't have even imagined like a year ago. Like a year ago, I thought Russia would just steamroll the piss out of Ukraine. I thought the war would be over in like a month. I thought Ukraine was going to be a part of Russia like immediately. But no, this thing's gone on. Now, granted, it's gone on because so much help from the other world governments, which is good. North Korea would be helping Russia. North Korea can't do shit. U.S. will switch over to a digital currency along with other countries of the world due to China or Russia at some point, probably during the switch. No, I don't foresee that happening. But, you know, we can, hey, you gave a good metric, a year, within the next year. So, do you mean by, like, April 5th of next year, or do you mean by, like, December? Well, I'll even give you till December 31st, 2024. That's fine. I'll give you that long. But North Korea can't, like, do anything. Like, North Korea can't even launch a missile properly. And China doesn't even want North Korea to fire a missile. Because if China really wanted North Korea to actually fire a missile that could hit the U.S., they could give them the technology. China has that technology. China's the one I'm... If we were to go to war with anyone, right now it'd be China that I'm worried about. It may not all take place in the time frame, but the framework would be there. I don't know, dude. I find that doubtful. I mean that respectfully, but I find that doubtful. Like, let's see here. One, I don't even know if Putin's going to be around in a year. Putin's been such a joke. The Russian people are not happy with him. I highly doubt that Putin will be around in a year. Xi Jinping seems to be doing a pretty good job. Like, not by my standards. I would never want to live in China. But his people seem to be, you know, 50-50 on him, kind of, I guess. From what I hear. I don't know, who knows how true that is. I don't know the stability of Brazil. Because didn't Brazil just have, like, huge... oh, god damn it. Let me just exit out of everything. Economy extremely close in the Fed. Have to keep saving it from going under a lot. Then it itself is scary. Have to prevent it from going under. Like, you mean from... I mean, we always print currency. That's just part of how economy works. But let me see here. Hold on. What's I doing? When I had the redacted video up, I'd like to finish that.
Those things and stuff.
And then two, what was the other thing? Brazil. Yeah, like Brazil can't even, like, Brazil's capital had a riot. People stormed their capital there. That country is like struggling. I mean, 2018 was a really good year for the economy, though. Unironically. Where'd you go? You said something. Yeah, so bad that they were eating paper to survive. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So you're, like, trying to talk about how, like... You're trying to talk about, like, how Brazil's going to be part of this, like, BRICS thing. And get some digital currency going. But, like, that's just super doubtful. To me, personally. China has a failing housing market. Their housing market is how people were investing for their future there. And the second biggest one was taking in money to finish projects and then using, like, a new project, starting a new, taking in more money for a new project to finish the current project over and over again, which is, like, a bad sign for a business. Let's see here. But apparently China's economy is going up. I can look. China's economy, I was just looking at it earlier today. 2023. I mean, they have the people for it. GRICS. print.in. What's a .in site? Where's that from? India? I'm just curious. Yeah, that's actually an Indian site. Okay, yeah. Okay, this website seems fucking weird as shit. Are you saying anything? Sorry. When the U.S. economy fully crashed, the dollar goes to zero, what do you think will happen? With all the manufacturing going on in other countries. The dollar's not going to go to zero, though. Like, you have no reason why the dollar would go to zero, because if, even at worst-case scenario, it can be backed by the gold in the Federal Reserve. That's worst-case scenario, which is not a good idea. We shouldn't back it to the Federal Reserve, but... What could lower the U.S. dollar? Decline in growth and corporate profits can cause investors to take their money elsewhere. Reduce investor interest in a particular country can weaken its currency as a currency speculator. They can bet against the currency, causing it to weaken further. Sir, you do know there is no gold in the reserve. No, it doesn't. You're right. Is the political insanity over yet? No. No, it's not. Gold certificates are denominated in U.S. dollars. Their value is based on the statutory price of gold at the time. Certificates. Gold certificates do not give the Federal Reserve any right to redeem certificates for gold. Statutory price of gold is set by law. It's not fluctuate. Blah, blah, blah. Okay, they were just set it to the price of gold. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, in exchange, the Secretary of Treasury issued gold certificates to the Federal Reserve for the amount of gold transferred at the then applicable statutory for gold held by the Treasury. At the then applicable statutory price for gold held. Yeah. No, I knew he got rid of it. I knew he broke the U.S. dollar so that it was no longer associated with the price of gold. But I didn't know that he got rid of the gold itself. But that's fine. Gold's pretty much worthless. It's only good as a conductor. I don't fear for the U.S. at all. I fear for people's jobs because I foresee automation replacing a lot of people's jobs, and I foresee that really sucking. But I don't fear for the U.S. economy itself. This is all the same rhetoric that I heard over 10 years ago. Oh, wait, I'm 32. So, 16 years ago. It's all the same rhetoric from Glenn Beck. Yeah, jobs equal an economy, and you're saying that manufacturing is the only job that is available out there. I would disagree on that, but you know, making goods for the rest of the world is very valuable. But let's see here. Gold economy, goods for the rest of the world. I've been up for like, what time is it? Thirty-nine hours? No, it's gotta be more than 39 hours. 12 to 12. 24 plus 12, 36 plus. No, I guess 39 hours, yeah. Don't like talking about stuff like this, but it was a good conversation. Well, the problem is that, honestly, dude, like, this is all stuff that Glenn Beck has said. Glenn Beck said this stuff 16 years ago. I used to watch Fox News with my dad then. Like, you know, I've heard it all. I've heard that, like, you know, buy corn, stock up on food cans, all this stuff. Buy gold, buy actual gold, put it in your fucking yard or whatever. Like, I've heard all this stuff for years, okay? Bricks, There's nothing that I'm even remotely worried about. It looks like what it is just Russia doesn't want to get kicked off of SWIFT, because nobody wants to get kicked off of SWIFT, because SWIFT is the only way that your economy can function with legitimate outside parties. Now, if they want to start something, their own little thing, they can do that. As far as I knew, India, U.S. ally? Yeah. One of the big problems is that all of these countries are severely screwing over their citizen base. And a lot of them are barely even stable to begin with. China's pretty stable. China's very stable. India, I don't know how stable India is. India has so many political parties. They're screwing over their population base. To really legitimately believe that they're going to overtake the world economy is ridiculous. They might be able to produce a lot at very cheap prices, but that's only good if, like, we're buying it. If we're not going to buy it anymore, or other countries aren't, then it's really no good whatever they sell their value at. All that savings is essentially being passed on to U.S. people, because we don't want to pay $1,500 for an iPhone because it was made in America. That isn't to say that our economy is going to fail. Manufacturing is good to have for sure. But we have tons of petroleum that gets sold. Integrated circuits get sold. Chip manufacturing is coming to America. And most of this stuff gets sold to Canada, Mexico, and Japan, and South Korea. With China being the third on the list for where this stuff is going. So, what are the U.S. top exports? Gas and other fuels, crude petroleum, civilian aircraft parts, LNG and other natural gases, passenger vehicles. Those are our big top five U.S. exports as of 2020. The main export destinations for these exports in October were India, Netherlands, and South Korea. So one, it's even hard to believe that India is going to overtake us with their apparently like superpower manufacturing if they're the ones that were well, that was for petroleum specifically. Gas went to Mexico mostly. Liquefied natural gas went to Mexico, France, UK. Civilian air parts, France, Germany, UK. Passenger vehicles, Canada, Germany, China. Regions, America, import, blah, 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 whatever. It's frankly not going to happen. Like, I'll give you 3 years even. I've heard Glenn Beck, Rush Limbaugh, I've heard Bill O'Reilly, I've heard Shep Smith never participated in it. I don't think Richard Ayers ever participated in it. I've heard all these people say for like the better part of 15 years, 16 years, you know, that the U.S. economy is going to fail. Everything's going to fall into ruin, like everything's going to be bad for 16 years, and it has not happened yet. It's very alarmist. We have recessions. That's a feature of our capitalist system, because, God, I love our capitalist system. It's the best goddamn system that's ever been goddamn created in this world. But that's a feature, because otherwise, it's just a full-on depression every 8 years. So the fact that we're avoiding depressions and going into recessions is a good thing. There's also tons of other, like, we also export a lot of culture, which is not something you can directly track. At least I would keep an eye on the BRICS stuff going on and the digital payment system launching in July from the Fed. If you notice, no news stations are talking about any of this. It's all about what Trump has done. It is always something going on behind the scenes. Well, okay, so Trump probably broke, Trump probably broke business fraud laws by changing the value of his business at key moments when it was beneficial for him to get better interest rates or tax rates, stuff like that. That's one thing he probably did. Now, I can't say it for certain. I have no idea on the actual legal stuff on it. He may also have broken campaign finance laws with whatever Stormy Daniel thing. Again, I have no idea. Like, I'm waiting until I hear the actual news thing on it. The other part, if you notice no news station, just because no news station has any reporting on it, like on a show, doesn't mean they're not reporting on it. For instance, tons of news stations were reporting on the train that had the chemical spill. Tons of news stations were reporting on that weeks before it went so viral and big. Like, it was already getting reported on. It just wasn't getting reported on like live TV shows. It was getting reported on in their articles. Like, don't get me wrong, like, you know, I'm not a person who believes that the U.S. economy, like, U.S. is always going to win no matter what. I believe the U.S. can have problems, like, for sure. But we are, I believe, how much medical supplies do we export? So Germany takes the number one spot of medical supplies. Hold on, wait. Let me be specific. List of countries by pharmaceutical exports. Germany, 60 billion. Switzerland, 48 billion. Belgium at 31 billion. France at 28 billion. Italy, 27 billion. United States at 24 billion. So, like, I mean, that's one thing that we're exporting for sure. If you look up the amount of derailment, you will find that they have increased dramatically in the past 2 years. May want to look into that as well. There is some sneaky stuff going on. No, that's not that sneaky, dude. Like, it's pretty obvious, like, they're overworked. And Biden probably shouldn't have, like, I don't know. If you want to be pro-union, then Biden probably should not have forced them to go back to work. I think the Biden administration did that. Biden administration train union. I mean, they're overworked, I think. And this is from The Guardian. I don't want to read it from The Guardian. I want to read it from somewhere else. Biden signs law bringing rail strike saga to an end. Months of chaotic negotiations that brought the nation to the brink of a rail shutdown that could have decimated the economy, but in so doing, Democrats have angered one of their key political constituents, ranked members of their own party for not including paid sick leave, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, they're overworked and underpaid. Like, I don't disagree. Like, I don't think they should have just been able to tell this union to go back to work. Like, that's not really fair to them. And, like, we need more, and I'm sure you'll agree with this, especially since you're, like, working on becoming a trucker and all that stuff, is, we need more trades, for sure. Like, trades are something that, trade school, trades, all that stuff, is something that we should really be pushing and promoting in America. Are literally the only thing keeping this economy running. Yeah, no, I don't disagree. Might just be a me problem. Check that Microsoft isn't screwing reading your PowerPoint from a flash drive. I'll check it out. I don't have PowerPoint on my computer, though, so, like, I'll have to, one, I'll put it on a flash drive, and I'll, I mean, it's on your OneDrive, though, so if you log into a computer at school, you can access your PowerPoint. So, worst case scenario, assuming you put your power, do you have PowerPoint on your computer, or did you do it on the OneDrive, Sparrow? Yeah, go ahead. Look, I love talking politics. You can, seriously, like, this, just so you know, Mr. Gamertech, this conversation could get super heated, and I would not be angry. I love it. I fucking love it. I'm on Windows 11. I got a laptop and my computer here on Windows 11. I actually really like Windows 11. I really, really like Windows 11, honestly. I do like it better than 10. Sometimes it's a bit sluggish in some areas that I don't like, but I like it better than 10. And there's some stuff that they reworked that I don't like. So, like, if I go to my volume, it's going to pull up a menu of a bunch of shit, usually. At least on the laptop it does. Maybe the laptop's using a little bit different UI. But, like, if you go into some of the settings to be like, oh, I'm going to look at microphone shit or whatever, it gets kind of weird in there. But that's just UI. Like, once you get a, you know, just got to adjust to that. But I like Windows 11, personally. Personally, I like Windows 11. Feels pretty fast, but, like, they also do the shit where it's, like, every year we're gonna, what was I saying? Sorry. They're gonna do that shit where it's, like, they keep using more and more RAM every fucking iteration, but, you know, what can you do about that? Because the laptop comes with it, just not sure how I will do it. Yeah, oh, it's fine. Windows 11 is fine. I love Windows 11. Yorinda had some problems with some games. Trying to think exactly what her problem. It was like old games though. It was like Fallout 3. She had problems with Fallout 3 on it, which we got fixed. It just it wasn't even a Fallout 3 thing. It was, or it wasn't even a Windows 11 thing. It was, oh, I guess it was kind of Windows 11. It was just an old thing that they no longer supported. I like Windows 11. My laptop runs on Windows 11. I don't have any problems with it. And I don't think it... Well, this might run a 3080 Ti. Mine might run a 3070. I think it runs a 3070. It doesn't have as much VRAM than the one that you linked earlier.
Uranium mining in the United States. We have one uranium mine in the United States. One. How did that happen?
We played some. She was getting a little stressed out over it. And I get it. I get where she's coming from. It gets a little unwieldy. We definitely played more Demonologist. But you were there for that, I thought. And then... what else were we playing? Well, we played Overcooked last night.
Oh yeah.
Her factory came along pretty well. Like, we're basically having to get into tier 6 stuff. I'm jumping into my satisfactory now. My storage building is ridiculous. I believe it.
They're leaking.
I don't know. I'll probably try and get her to get back into it soon. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see how she feels about it. I don't think... I don't know. It is what it is.
As we've reported here, that the United States was a pioneer in uranium mining.
Right.
Industry.
So we
I don't who cares about uranium mining? How much uranium GDP? What even is the... Like, how much uranium's even being bought? I don't even know. Do we even want to be selling uranium? Also, the US exports the most uranium. The US generates around 30% of the world's nuclear power. Yeah, so we're even... Wait, hold on. So what did she say? Hold on, when was this? This was updated October 2022, and this was posted 13 days ago. So
we, you know, we gave.
What the fuck are they talking
exchanging
about?
Exchanging energy, minerals, metals, chemicals. What else is on their list?
Things that they actually mine,
right,
and control. We've done reports here about how the United States does have
You're
a lot
leaking.
Of these resources, but environmental groups are stopping the mining of those things. And so, if you want your nice electronics and smart cars. And EVs, you're not going to be able to get them from American manufacturing.
We don't do any uranium mining in the United States. We have one uranium mine in the United States. One!
What the fuck is this guy... Okay, so what's this guy's problem? Explain that one to me, Mr. Gamer Tech, because, like, we export the most uranium to the world.
Moab.
We export... U.S. generates around 30% of the world's nuclear power. Much of the 21,200 tons comes from Canada, but Australia's... I'm wrong. This is the other way. We're receiving... Australia's sending us up to 5,000 tons of uranium. How much is a ton? Ton... 2,204. So, well, I would not go based off of what he says or anyone says. I will always do my own research after hearing something. Calculator 21000 divided by 2204. U.S. uranium mine produced 21,000 pounds of uranium concentrate. Production data was withheld in 2020, but 2021 production was down 88% from 2019. Production levels, the production of uranium concentrate is the first step to nuclear fuel production. Employment expenditures, total employment in the U.S. uranium production. Decreased 8% from 2020 for all expenditures for land exportation. Yeah, I don't even know if this is a problem, but it could be. It could be a problem. But it's not like, I don't think it's, I highly doubt it's at the same degree.
How did that happen?
Even
because
though,
we're idiots.
As we've reported here, the United States was pioneers in the uranium mining industry.
Right. So we gave that away. This is all a man-made disaster, by the way. You can see it, right? We could have been leading that charge, but instead we're not. So metals, chemicals, minerals—they signed these 14 total agreements, including nuclear energy, with a shared cooperation of building faster neutron reactors. The governments also agreed to create a new joint television station that would share information. These guys over the past few days, like shaking hands, and they seemed like they were like best friends, you know, in these meetings. Oil exports to China have exploded. And another area of agreement moving forward is on this massive new pipeline, the Mongolian pipeline, from Russia to China. So. Massive new oil and hydrocarbon pipeline through from Russia to China.
Now, I've seen some comments online that...
think that pipeline got blown up. I don't know the specifics on it. I just know that like something happened to a pipeline. That could based off what he said. Yeah, yeah.
But Joe Biden made this possible because it could be interpreted that nothing brings people together like a common enemy. And as they continue to be, you know, the butt of aggression from the United States, then of course they're motivated
is on this massive new pipeline, the Mongolian pipeline, from Russia to China. So massive new oil and hydrocarbon pipeline through from Russia to China.
Now, I've seen some comments online that Joe Biden made this possible because it could be interpreted that nothing brings people together
like
a common enemy. And as they continue to be, you know, the butt of aggression from the United States, then of course they're motivated to make this work more than ever before.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. And now they know they have this common threat. They are under siege, basically. Right. So they see this happening with the United States aggression in the South China Sea, military bases, weapons, money into Taiwan, nuclear weapons, nuclear submarines into Australia. You know, I mean, the list is pretty much endless. Yeah, David.
Well, I was going to say, and let's talk so about sanctions. All of these countries that know that at any moment, if they do anything outside of what we say they can, sanctions on them, and they're going to be like, wait, we might not have to have sanctions on us anymore, because let's not, you know, forget, sanctions are basically an act of war.
Yes.
Yeah, actually, the weapons of, you know, what was it, the
sanctions
of
mass destruction.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So they also signed a new military partnership. They'll have a military exchange and cooperation program with mutual trust between their armed forces. They're also going to regularly conduct joint maritime and air patrol military exercises together. Their goal, they say, is and now they know. Oh, they have Taiwan, nuclear weapons, nuclear submarines.
If they do anything outside of what we say they can, sanctions on them, and they're going to be like, wait, we might not have to have sanctions on us anymore, because let's not, you know, forget, sanctions are basically an act of war.
Yes.
Yeah, actually, the weapons of, you know.
Okay, sanctions are not an act of war.
What was it, the sanctions of
that's
mass
a bit.
Destruction? Yeah.
That's a bit
so
overstated.
They also signed a new military partnership. They'll have a military exchange and cooperation program with mutual trust between their armed forces.
Who?
Line that.
Oil exports to China.
Russia and China.
They are under spin.
Russia hasn't even been funding its own military.
Nuclear submarines.
Like, that's
Australia.
Shown by, like, their tire rot.
I mean, the list is pretty much.
And, like, it's actually kind of sad. I feel bad for the Russian people because, or at least some of these people fucking fighting this war. I don't know if you've seen the video of them, like, hitting mines left and right. It's really actually tragic. It's kind of, like. Is this the one? Like, I don't know if you've seen this. Like, I do not fear Russia, even remotely. The only thing that Russia could do that I would fear is nuclear. God, they cannot conduct this military. Like, their oligarchs have been clearly not. They've been clearly stealing money from their military. The corruption's, like, so prevalent that they're not funding their military. They're not funding proper maintenance on their trucks, on their vehicles. They're getting tire rot. Like, they're not even rotating tires. They're letting the rubber dry out in the sun, stuff like that. Like, I don't think Russia can do much of anything. The only thing I think they could do is nuclear missiles. That's the thing that they could do that scares me. And last I heard, because the Ukraine war is going so shit for them, that they wanted to argue that it's no longer an asymmetrical battle, but an asymmetrical one. Which means that then they can do anything to win, up to including nukes. I hope they don't try and do that.
So about
that's
sanctions,
really stupid.
All of these countries that know that at any moment, if they do anything outside of what we say they can, sanctions on them, and they're going to be like,
weapons of mass destruction.
Yeah. So they also signed a new military partnership. They have a military exchange and cooperation program with mutual trust between their armed forces.
I mean, that's probably true, but I already assumed that to be true.
Conduct joint maritime and air patrol military exercises together. Their goal, they say, is a multipolar world order instead of a unipolar U.S.-led world order. That was this.
We're not unipolar, though. We're bipolar. We're a bipolar system, not a unipolar. Some people do like to argue that we're a unipolar, though. Do they? Do you know what a polar system is, though? Gotcha, okay. So basically, it just means, like, how many, things are keeping it balanced. So basically, like, arguably, so when they say that we're unipolar, what they're trying to say is that the U.S. is so strong and powerful that we run the entire world. Bipolar would mean that there are two powers that are equally powerful and that they together are keeping each other in check and balanced. And then multipolarity would be like the EU. All the countries in the EU are combined together to keep everything balanced, shit like that. But so arguably we're bipolar because we probably used to think it was America and Russia. It ain't Russia. Whatever it is, it ain't Russia, apparently. But I do think China. I think China keeps track of their stuff.
Why is this not like the lead story on every major newspaper or newscast? It's not. The third thing that they discussed was the Ukrainian peace proposal. Why is this also not one of the lead stories on the nightly newscasts?
Okay, it's not a nightly, it's not a lead story because the terms of which Russia wants to offer peace is like they keep Crimea and they keep other places, like they keep Kiev and the Donbass.
Peace in Ukraine? Why not lead your newscasts with that? Let's see if Lester Holt tonight on NBC's Nightly News leads with that story. Probably not.
Also, Ukraine does not have to take a peace offering if Ukraine does not want to, and they do not want to. That is up to their country. If their country wanted to join Russia, their country could join Russia. Like, that's up to them. That's up to their president, Zelensky, and whatever their people are doing.
So they put this forth by China. China put this 12-part framework together about peace in Ukraine. Putin praised this 12-part peace plan, saying he's ready for it, but the United States and the West are not ready for peace. Here is President Putin talking about.
Okay, for starters, about this 12-point peace plan from February 24th, Russia's been sending tanks in still, so I guess Russia really, I don't trust anything from Putin at all. He can say he wants to be a part of it all he wants, doesn't matter. I don't trust a single word he says at all. What's the 12-point peace plan? I want to read it. China threatened ties with Russia. Chinese President Xi Jinping left. China's plan for peace, outlined in 12 points, consists of the following: respecting the sovereignty of all countries, abandoning the Cold War mentality, ceasing hostilities, resuming peace talks, blah, 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 a bunch of shit, which they're not practicing with the Uyghurs, but whatever. A key complaint of the position paper is the increased influence of military blocs across the globe, which, okay. How does this threaten their... The U.S. is in no position to tell China what to do. I agree. The U.S. can... Okay. The U.S. can say, China, don't do it. The U.S. can put sanctions on China for doing it. But we cannot physically force them not to give Russia weapons. If China wants to give Russia weapons, China can give Russia weapons. If they're not attacking a NATO member, I don't think... I think our hands are virtually tied. But what does this mean? China threatens ties with Russia. What do they fucking mean by that? China threatens ties with Russia, claiming both promote world peace despite Ukraine. Oh, Titans. Titans. Oh my god, I was misreading that like an idiot. Jesus. Titans ties. Okay, let's read their plan for peace. Respecting the sovereignty of all countries. Okay, so it wants to respect the UN charters, okay. I don't know if Ukraine counts as part of that. I don't know if Ukraine was part of the USSR when it was created. I do know one thing for sure. What scares me is Putin being put in a place where he sees no way out. He will launch nukes. He is a killer. He was cleaning for the KGB. Plus, he has killed his own people. Yeah, no, dude. Like, there's a bad case of, you know, falling out windows in Russia if you oppose Putin. That dude's crazy. And that's what I was saying earlier, is that Russia might be looking at it now saying, because Ukraine has received so much technology and aid from other countries, that it's no longer asymmetrical, and it is now a symmetrical war. And if it's symmetrical, then they can do anything. They can try and win by any means, which could include up to nuclear weapons. I hope he realizes how insane that is, but I think he is insane, so I doubt he would. Okay, here's the problem with China's 12-point peace plan. It doesn't in here at all mention Russia giving Ukraine their territory back. It doesn't say anything about that at all. Here. All parties should support Russia and Ukraine in working in the same direction and resuming direct dialogue as quickly as possible as to gradually de-escalate the situation. I totally agree. But that should require Russia giving that territory back. If others do nothing to help them, Putin will not stop. No, he won't stop. You know, and I respect all these countries who have stepped up and provided aid to Ukraine. Ukraine's their own country. If Ukraine wants to join NATO, they can do that. And if Ukraine wants to defend itself, they can do that. But this 12-point plan is shit. I don't know why they're promoting it like it's a fucking golden goose.
Что многие из положений выдвинутого Китаем мирного плана созвучны российским подходом и могут быть взяты за основу для мирных.
Now, actually, we talked about this in class too. Is that Russian or Putin is probably looking for a way out because they have been getting their ass kicked. It is not looking good for them on the world stage. This shit looks really bad. I was talking in class about how I feel bad for China because China's over here thinking like, hey, Russia's probably a good ally of ours. Like, they've got our back, and they're pretty powerful and strong. Apparently not. Apparently, they couldn't even keep track of their trucks.
такой подход пока урегулирования, когда к нему будут готовы на Западе и в Киеве. Однако такой подход.
If Russia wants peace with Ukraine, they just have to stop. This is like total bullshit that they're like, it's ridiculous that this redacted channel is trying to present it like, hey, Putin wants peace. If they want peace, all they have to do is stop. Like, they don't obviously want peace. It's so fucking obvious. Like, that was just blatantly obvious. Like, I'll agree maybe with some of the other stuff. Maybe there are concerns on, like, should we be producing uranium? Are, like, you know, environmentalist groups blocking production of mineral, you know, mining, stuff like that in America? Whatever. But it is so blatantly obvious that if they just want peace, they just have to pull back and stop. Because Ukraine doesn't want the war.
Такой готовности с их стороны мы не наблюдаем. В то время, когда мы с председателем обсуждали вопрос возможности реализации китайского плана мирного урегулирования, председатель КНР уделил большое внимание своим мирным инициативам в ходе нашей вчерашней беседы с глазу на глаз.
Yeah, this peaceful initiative that doesn't require anything on Russia's part. It just says respect the UN Charter on what sovereignty is. Don't build your, you know, military block mentality, stuff like that. But it doesn't say like, hey, Russia, you know, stop being a dick or whatever. It just says, you know, Ukraine, Russia, come to the table to talk. Which, granted, they could sort that out at the table, potentially. Probably not.
Сегодня стало известно, что...
Yeah. So we're ready for it. You know who's not ready for it? He says, the West and Ukraine. They're not ready for peace. So...
That's what I'm talking about. Like, it's not the West or Ukraine. It's Putin.
We'll just keep fighting till the last Ukrainian. That's been the plan, of course, all along. And then...
Okay.
The Chinese president got on an airplane and started to fly home. They shook hands. They were caught on camera talking about how this will be the greatest change to the world in 100 years. And Putin said, I agree, my friend, and have a safe journey. Watch this.
Перемены, которые не было в течение 100 лет. Там, где вместе, двигаем эти перемены. Берегите, пожалуйста, дорогие, дорогой друг.
He even walks him out to the car like he's on a date.
Yeah.
You know? It's like, get home
Jesus
safe,
Christ,
okay? Get home safe. You're my new best friend.
Text me.
Call me when
you get
back.
Didn't open the door for him.
Hey, it's Vlad.
Sure, but I thought at one time all of Ukraine was a part of Russia. Something happened to it. It branched off, and Russia thought it owned Ukraine. I can't remember how. Okay. Ukraine, Belarus, a couple other places, whatever. Chechnya. I don't fucking know where. They're part of the USSR. So there's the Soviet bloc. Sweet delicious jelly beans, sorry. So you have your Soviet bloc, which has all these countries in it. USSR dissolves. In the process, they had made agreements that these countries could basically put their own leaders in, which they did. And that they would not go to war with each other. That even though they were going to become their own countries, they were still going to be remaining unified in some aspects of their world. So Ukraine was part of the USSR. Putin most likely wants to rebuild the USSR. However, Ukraine's its own country. Like, ultimately. Like, Russia has legitimate reasons to, like, not want the expansion of NATO. Sure. But NATO's not initiating conflict.
I'm up late. What are you doing? What are you doing?
He's asking his officials, when is too soon to text back?
Right. Right. Is it a little too pushy for me to keep texting early? Like, But I mean, this is the type of relationship that we see growing. It's unbelievable to watch this. And what relationships does the United States have in this way right now? Think about the tale of two summits, right? President Biden flying into Saudi Arabia to try to push them for more oil production, right?
Yeah.
Agreements with Saudi Arabia. Instead, what did Saudi Arabia do? It turns out, we know from reports, they ended up mocking President Biden behind his back after he left. They called him like a fool, and then they turned around and basically started moving more closely with China.
Okay, so what that was is like an SNL program, apparently, which, whatever, who cares?
What Saudi Arabia did.
Like, they spent years making fun of Trump. I'm not gonna, like, who cares if they want to make a SNL program making fun of Biden?
So, have a safe voyage back. So, this was all happening, while at the same time, the world is being upended, reordered. That's what was happening.
Okay, now he's trying to push for great replacement bullshit, but that's a big can of worms.
What was happening in Washington, D.C. while this was happening in Moscow? President Biden handing out a war.
I'm sorry, not great replacement. Great global reset.
It's two Hollywood actresses. Watch. This
great replacement, something else.
Giving voice to a new generation of storytellers, imbued with humor and heart. Mindy Kaling's work.
Who the?
It's a Medal of Honor or Freedom or whatever. Like, who the fuck cares? This is so stupid. They criticized Obama of this too. And I forget if. I thought Trump gave it out to some people too, but who gives a shit? It's just a medal.
Dress with no nylons.
It's just It's just a PR event. That's all it is.
Did not get that.
And I was really self-conscious that you didn't know
him. So President Biden, literally, I mean, handing out awards to actresses. Now, in Mindy Kaling's defense, she did defend J.K. Rowling for speaking out in support of women. The woke mob freaked out when she liked J.K. Rowling's tweet. Remember this?
Mm.
People were like, what? Mindy Kaling likes this tweet as a parent of a trans child and a non-binary child.
I don't care about Twitter bullshit.
I hope I'm misreading that she liked a tweet by J.K. Rowling.
How dare you?
How dare you? Right.
No, but people have lost their jobs for liking J.K. Rowling's tweet.
Yeah.
It's more insidious than that.
Well, but then she also released a woke television show on HBO on this Velma remake of like Scooby-Doo thing. It's been bombed as one of the lowest rated.
They both praise her and are criticizing her at the same time. That's ridiculous.
Ever on Rotten Tomatoes. On
I don't think they have like a solid.
I watched it.
Woke piece of garbage. Is it a woke piece of garbage?
Solid like message here.
Oh my god! I literally cringed the whole entire time. Didn't laugh one.
I don't think anyone liked it though. I don't know why they're calling it woke garbage because I don't think anyone liked it. Did anyone like Velma? Velma rating. Yeah, it's got like a 1.3. Or 40%. It's got like a 1.5 on IMDb, 40% on Rotten Tomatoes. I bet if I look at the user score, it's probably lower on Rotten Tomatoes. Yeah, it's 7%. Like, nobody likes it. I don't know why they're blaming it on like being woke or not. I guess I never watched it to know if it's woke or not.
But I had to watch
this. Is really
it
dumb.
I had to know what everybody was talking about, so I watched three episodes of it.
So was it woke? Hold on. Mr. Gamertech, was it woke? I don't know. Like, I assume what they're complaining about it being woke is that it had black characters in it, but... Like, that's whatever. Like, I don't... Oh, yeah, it was woke beyond that? Okay.
So that's what the White House is doing, handing out awards for that. Like, literally at the same moment. Same moment in Washington. That's the priority of Washington right now. The banking crisis. I mean, an economy slipping into ruin. And
okay, the president doesn't do anything for a banking crisis. That's the Senate. That's the Senate and the House of Representatives. Oh, I mean, that's fine, I guess. I don't know.
This is what we're doing.
I don't know. I've seen people like sort of portray that for like years.
They just did where they had the whole cast of Ted Lasso behind Jean-Pierre?
Yeah.
They bring what is going on?
They bring the cast of Ted Lasso to the White House. Like, I love that show. It's a great show. What the hell?
Well, I can tell you what the hell, because what the United States is really good at is exporting culture. And
they said it. I told you.
Hollywood sort of acts as a mouthpiece for why it's cool to be an American. And we are expats, so we understand how that, like, we get cool points just because of our accent from a lot of people who say, oh, I watch American YouTube, I watch American shows, I learned English from friends. Like, we do hear this a lot. And so if you can sort of double down on this as PR in a time when nothing else about your, not your social media censorship, so that's of course why you double down on that.
Okay, hold on.
Your banking certainly not your health system.
Not your bullying of through military.
Right, not your social media censorship.
There was no signs of any social media censorship. I'm waiting for you to say something now. There was no signs that the FBI or any other intelligence agency participated in any direct censorship. And I've even heard arguments that Twitter's response to the FBI and the CIA actually instilled more confidence in the actual freedom of information and all that shit. People being able to communicate on it.
Not your non-scientific COVID rules. Nothing here is worth exporting, except we're really good at movies and TV shows and music.
Yeah.
And so that's, of course, why you double down on that. It's not for nothing. It's absolutely not...
So it's propaganda.
Gratuitous.
Yeah.
Absolutely, it's propaganda.
Yeah, it's total propaganda. So rather than...
I mean, yeah, it's propaganda. Duh.
Ask tough questions at the press corps. Let's bring the cast of Ted Lasso here so we don't have to take tough questions. And then you had that African reporter trying to ask questions of Jean-Pierre while the cast of Ted Lasso was in the room. And he's like, are you ever going to call on me? It's been 9 months now or 7 months you haven't called on me. This is a...
About what? Sorry. Go down in Congress about that, but not sure about it being... About them censoring Twitter? No, they didn't censor Twitter. Arguably, Twitter's having a harder time censoring not getting censored internationally, because the U.S. is very based. We have a ton of freedom of speech laws that are very, very fucking good. Our freedom of speech laws are fucking amazing compared to the rest of the world. I don't care what other people say, their freedom of speech laws suck ass compared to ours. In Germany, you can get in trouble just for saying certain things. In the U.K., the slander laws are like super fucking ridiculous. It's easy to get your ass sued just for like implying things. In Japan, I don't even think you can talk about politics positively or negatively. I think you can do it positively, but you can't say anything negative. You can't criticize the government at all in any public fashion. If you're like a news anchor, you can't do it at all. It is wild. Our freedom of speech laws are based as fuck. What had happened was the FBI, I believe it was the FBI. If it wasn't the FBI, it was the CIA. But I'm pretty sure, 99% sure, that it was the FBI. They sent emails to Twitter to, I can't think of his name. He was on Joe Rogan like multiple times. Jack, it's not Bauer, it's not Bowser. Jack. Twitter CEO Jack Reacher, why not? They sent emails to Jack Dorsey at Twitter. Well, they didn't send it directly to Jack Dorsey. They sent it to Twitter, and then the internal conversations between Jack Dorsey and the employees were, what is the tweet? Does this tweet actually violate our TOS? And they had internal conversations about how what the FBI was suggesting that they should possibly be removing was a suggestion. They were never told to remove them, which would be violating freedom of speech. But what Twitter agreed was, this thing that they are asking us to remove does not actually violate our terms of service, and as such, we're going to leave it up. We're not going to remove it. So if the FBI was like, you need to take this down, and Twitter did not comply, well then, if they had some kind of legal ramifications from that, then we'd have some freedom of speech problems. But the FBI made their suggestions, Twitter disagreed, and that was it. So it's actually, like, I don't know, pretty good. It actually, like, I know, like, the way it's being spun is, like, ridiculous. A lot of people are talking, like, oh, fuck, you know, this clearly showed that there was freedom of speech violations or whatever. The FBI is trying to censor stuff, which, again, was also under Trump, but whatever. He's going to argue that you have your own people who have their own agendas within it. Possibly true. I don't fucking know. But no ramifications came to Twitter from not following the suggestions. So
egregious. And the cast of Ted Lasso is kind of like standing there like, whoa, this is uncomfortable.
Yeah.
United States, while this is happening, is busy bailing out failed banks. That's what we're doing right now. And it's handing probably, out awards to Hollywood actors and actresses.
Whatever's going on in, fuck, where is it at? The tech bank. Silicon Valley Bank.
It is. But the U.S., the United States is preparing a massive strike of new Russian against new Russian territories. Their sources say that the United States and NATO forces will see the biggest strikes happening in the coming weeks, and that Ukraine is carrying out these attacks. Ukraine is done. This is the United States and NATO forces carrying out these attacks. So anytime you see the word Ukraine is carrying out attacks, just...
You know that's ridiculous, right? What's their justification for that?
Industrial complex is alive and well and is ready to launch a massive offensive against Russia. According to the German newspaper Bild this morning, the United States is preparing a massive strike of new Russia in...
Fuck, I love jelly beans! Well, there is no benefit other than we're getting a new NATO ally. So the benefit to NATO and everything is that the fuck is this crazy website? Okay, this website that they're referencing just so you know, the website that they are referencing in their thing from Bild? Fuck, did I exit out of it? Shit, I think I did. Hold on. Let's go back to YouTube. History.
Against new...
Okay, this website that they're referencing is unironically I don't even know what this fucking site is. Like, they're selling books, they're selling power, their batteries, they're selling pants, they're selling NFL stuff, they're selling watches. What even is this website? This website is wild. This might be the craziest website I've ever seen. What even is this company? I don't even know what this is. What are they? Because they sell like garden stuff. Like, they sell strawberries. and lawn chairs. And what? Oh my! What is this site? Here. Okay. So hold on. Wait. Let me go to the article that they have pulled up specifically. I don't wanna start somewhere else. Okay. Here's the website that they have in their thing. And it takes you to an ad block, because fucking... Yeah, sure, I'll totally take it down. Yeah, I'm not going to take my ad block off. It looks like, God, it looks like that Sun Inquirer thing. But, like, all I did was just click on their shop, because I just was, like, curious. Like, because I was doing that paywall, or, yeah, I was doing that, hey, turn off your ad blocker bullshit. So I was like, oh, well, I'll click on that, because they probably won't block that. And this is like... I'm so confused at what this, like, maybe they do new stuff? I'm just so confused at the, like, wide range of whatever they're covering. I'm mystified. I'm intrigued now, because like they're not just selling politics, they're also selling like other stuff, like lifestyle, which is I guess mostly clothing. Fan shop, I don't know what this is. It's probably like Arizona Cardinals. They sell like NFL stuff. It's so bizarre. Like, buy a weed whacker. It was not what I was expecting. I just expected that they'd have, like, personal merchandise of, like, shirts of their company or something like that. You know what I mean? Like, something silly. Something small. Like, get this, like, whatever, coasters with our company on. Because I thought it was going to be, like, a news company or something. What do they do? Like, and if you go back, like, this looks like, Yeah, my ad blocker kicked in and don't want to mess with it. Yeah, all I'm saying is like, yeah, so my ad blocker kicked in too, and it's like, hey, remove it. And I didn't do that. So I just clicked on build shop. Yeah, probably a little bit. But hold on, let me see what they're saying.
Territories. Their sources say that the United States and NATO forces will see the biggest strikes happening in the coming weeks against Russia. Now, if you watched our show last night, you realize we are no longer on this show saying that Ukraine is carrying out these attacks. Ukraine is done. This is the United States and NATO forces carrying out these attacks. So anytime you see the word Ukraine is...
The only like credit I'm going to give him there is that fact that NATO forces are doing training. Like, so we're sending them stuff, we're sending them equipment, we're sending them all this stuff, whatever, and then we're training them how to use it. NATO's training them how to use it. It blurs the lines. NATO's not directly involved. NATO's not fighting the war for them. NATO's not driving the tanks for them or shooting the missiles or firing the mortars, but they're teaching them how to do everything. So it's like, how involved are you without saying that you're involved? I don't know. That one, if I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt, I think he's trying to say literally that NATO is doing it, which is not true. That's not even remotely true. But if I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt, he's trying to say, this would be nothing without NATO. Therefore, this is NATO's doing, not Ukraine. Which, sure.
Carrying out a just scratch whatever. That out and put U.S. That's in its place from now on and NATO forces. So that's exactly what's happening against Russia. So while refusing to go into detail on this regarding planned operations, according to this Build article, the official at NATO asserted that Ukrainian forces and U.S. forces, of course, led by U.S. forces, will focus their efforts on the regions of Zaporizhia and Lugansk. The U.S. will attack the land bridge to Crimea. That's good.
U.S. attack land bridge to Crimea. There is no reporting on this.
But Ukraine is carrying out a... just scratch that out. And put U.S. in its place from now on, and NATO forces. So that's exactly what's happening against Russia. So while refusing to go into detail on this regarding planned operations, according to this Build article, The official at NATO asserted that Ukrainian forces and U.S. forces, of course, led by U.S. forces, will focus their efforts on the regions of Zaporizhia and Lugansk. The U.S. will attack the land bridge to Crimea.
This could just be a bad translation, since this is like a German website. Maybe this guy does not have a good translation, but there is nothing out there saying that U.S. is attacking land bridge to Crimea. In fact, I think some of the stuff about peace talks was whether or not Russia would get to continue to hold the land bridge or not. But there, I searched this. U.S. attacking land bridge. NATO attacking land bridge. There's nothing out there except for like wild YouTube videos. There's nothing. Nothing's out there.
Crimea. That's good. So the United States is going to attack the land bridge to Crimea. That's
not true.
The plan.
That's a lie. That's a straight up lie. That's a lie. Now, he could say the U.S. is helping guide Ukrainians on how they should attack the land bridge. That could be one thing. And maybe that's what he's trying to convey, but literally saying the U.S. is attacking the land bridge is a lie.
He's this as a do or die moment for the war. Britain also getting in on this offensive. According to the U.K.'s defense minister, Annabel Goldie, Britain will be sending depleted uranium shells to Ukraine. Wait, what the hell? Did you not watch? Like, we had a whole report on depleted uranium just a few weeks ago here on the show. And why, that's a really bad idea.
How much do you know about this guy? How much do you know about this Clayton Morris guy? You know a lot about him? You know he was defrauding people? He had how many counts? Hold on. 24 lawsuits from investors who say he defrauded them. It's from IndyStar, which I've never heard of, so I looked for another article. The Daily Beast. I feel like that's like some spinoff thing of the Daily Wire. I don't fucking know. Yeah, so this is why he left Fox News. He left Fox News because he defrauded a bunch of people. Apparently, according to these. I don't actually, now admittedly, I don't see like a big, like actual. No, he didn't. Okay, that's pretty stupid. It links back to their own article. Left Fox News to defraud them in real estate. No, I think it seemed like he fled the country is what they're implying here. That he fled to Portugal with his wife. Isn't the Daily Beast like supposed to be one of the... No, hold on, wait. This one looks pretty wild too. Hold on. I don't know if I trust this site. Cheat sheet, obsessed, politics, crime, entertainment. Yeah, this looks like another one of those like build-esque websites. Morris has been accused by investors of running a Ponzi scheme, selling them homes in Indianapolis with promises to fix up their properties. Indianapolis Star. Rehabilitation efforts, and the investor said he never happened. According to the Indianapolis Star, the investors accused... I think it's only the Indianapolis Star reporting on this. I wasn't too crazy about their website. I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't believe this. In March 2019, investors filed more than two dozen lawsuits in Indianapolis and New Jersey claiming that Morris was running a Ponzi scheme involving the sales of some homes in C-minus and D-minus class neighborhoods that were marketed through his investment company, Morris Invest. In Indianapolis, the investors claimed that they were sold rental properties which Morris Invest promised to rehabilitate, rent out. Others found that they had purchased vacant lots, small shacks of buildings that were falling down. Morris denied responsibility, asserting he referred investors to Whalen and that Whalen was responsible for managing the properties, even though many investors believe they were dealing directly with Morris. In November 2019, Whalen was indicted. Whalen, the company that he was apparently sending them to. Whalen was indicted by a federal grand jury for defrauding investors. The indictment did not name Morris. Okay. Whalen pleaded guilty. Morris sued Holton Wise TV in federal court October 2019, alleging copyright infringement. Case stemmed from Holton Wise's TV production. Okay, that was something else. The state of Indiana filed a civil suit against Clayton Morris, among others, for violating Indiana's Deceptive Sales and Home Loans Act. Okay, so maybe if I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt, he's saying that he didn't actually know. He was directing it to this other company, and he was just... Was his company sold, sued? Yeah, something went down, but I'm not 100% sure. Yeah, I mean, it's possible that his company was... It's possible that his company was just, like, directing people to it. I don't know. It seems fishy, but it's definitely not...
The UK
smoking
is saying
gun.
Depleted uranium shells, and this isn't like a
it's no,
a random report. This comes from the defense ministry,
D'Souza or whatever.
UK, this isn't like some rumor.
Who's actually committed voter fraud?
So they're going to be used in their Challenger 2 tanks. These are armor-piercing weapons that cause cancer. If you needed any more evidence that the West wants the destruction of Ukraine, then look no further. Putin responded to the UK defense minister announcing these new shell deliveries. Listen to President Putin.
Did he misspeak there?
So they're going to be used in their Challenger 2 tanks. These are armor-piercing weapons that cause cancer. If you needed any more evidence that the West wants the destruction of Ukraine, then look no further. Putin.
I think he misspoke there. I think he meant Russia, right? I mean, that's just a misspeak. They probably should have caught that in editing, but whatever. People misspeak.
Responded. Crimea. That's good. So the United States is going to attack the land bridge to Crimea.
Not true.
That's the plan. The sources say that the United States sees this as a do or die moment for the war. Britain also getting in on this offensive. According to the UK's defense minister, Annabel Goldie, Britain will be sending depleted uranium shells to Ukraine. Wait, what the hell? Did you not... Like, we had a whole report on depleted uranium just a few weeks ago here on the show. And why, that's a really bad idea. The UK is sending depleted uranium shells. And this isn't like a random report. This comes from the Defense Ministry of UK. This isn't like some rumor. They're admitting it. So they're going to be used in their Challenger 2 tanks. These are armor-piercing weapons that cause cancer. If you needed any more evidence that the West wants the destruction of Ukraine, then look no further. Putin responded to the UK defense minister announcing these new shell deliveries. Listen to President Putin.
Что Великобритания устами заместителя главы Министерства обороны этой страны объявила не только о поставках танков на Украину, но и снарядов с обеднённым ураном. Похоже, что Запад действительно решил воевать с Россией до последнего украинца уже не на словах, а на деле. Но хотел бы в этой связи отметить, что если все это будет происходить, то соответствующим образом Россия вынуждена будет реагировать, имея в виду, что коллективный Запад начинает применять уже оружие с ядерным компонентом.
Yeah. So we...
I don't know if I would call that a nuclear component. I mean, it's uranium, sure. I think he's trying to imply vaguely. I don't even know what these do. As a tamper or neutron and fission bombs, a high-density tamper like DU makes a longer lasting, more energetic, and more efficient explosion. Okay. International Court of Justice gave an advisory opinion on legality of the threat or use of nuclear weapons. Okay, so they do consider it. This made it clear in paragraph 54, 55, and 56 that international law on poisonous weapons, the Second Hague Declaration of 29, July 1899. I don't even care if it causes cancer. Because what he's saying is, if I'm understanding it correctly, is that it causes cancer. Hold on, let me read it, because I want to understand it. Like, they shoot it, it explodes, and then it causes cancer around the people that it explodes near, or it causes cancer to the people who are loading it. That's what I want to understand. Because the guy definitely at least misspoke. Rich uranium was for, okay, yeah, production and availability, uranium hexalloid. Okay. Okay, so in 2007, a bunch of people have been calling for the cease, no longer using it. Well, so I didn't know if he was saying it causes, because the way he says it is really dumb.
We'll respond. Challenger 2 tanks.
Because you can hear it
these
himself.
These are armor-pierced uranium shells to Ukraine. Wait, what the hell? Did you not, what, like, we had a whole report on depleted uranium just a few weeks ago here on the show. And why that's a really bad idea. The UK is sending depleted uranium shells, and this isn't like a random report. Tanks.
Come on.
These are armor-piercing weapons that cause cancer. If you needed any more evidence that the West wants the destruction of Ukraine...
See, I think he means Russia there. So if it's like, oh, you shoot them, it pierces armor, and then it causes cancer? But I don't know. I'd have to think on how I feel about that. Like, is it, if I gave you an option where you're going to get shot with, or you're either going to get shot with a gun A, which is going to kill you immediately, you're going to bleed out and you're going to die, or you're going to get shot with gun B, which could give you cancer, which you could get treated potentially. I'm not saying that it's super treatable. It's probably not. Most people are going to die from it for sure. Oh, she's on her way. Cool. Oh, it is 4:30. I gotta start getting ready soon. How much is left? 11 minutes. All right, I'm gonna put this on 1.5.
Responded to
all I'm saying is, like, I don't know how I feel about that.
Shell deliveries.
I'd have to think on it. I'd really have to think on how I feel about whether or not I care if they get cancer or not. I mean, cancer sucks. It's a terrible way to go. But I don't know if it's better or worse than being shot.
Yeah. So we will respond accordingly. So what? Nuclear war? World War III?
What's also so frustrating, they just talk about taking out this bridge and not even talking about, like, what an inconvenience that's going to be to both sides. Like, they think, well, we can inconvenience Russia, but, you know, that's going to inconvenience everyone in that territory that uses that bridge.
Yeah, we're going to
cut off
that entire area. Well, the land bridge and what other... We're going to take that out again, too? Just the land bridge, it cutting that whole area off? People who want to be a part of Russia, they do not want to have anything to do with Ukraine? Go ahead, Phil. I was going to say, it's...
Okay, those people that want to be part of Russia were part of an election in the Donbass, which was, like... they were given two options: join Russia now or join Russia later. And it was severely, severely rigged, from my understanding. Like, to the point where, like, more people voted than people lived there, I believe. Like, it's clearly, that was clearly, like, a Russian meddling one.
NATO is, like, it's not like they're gearing up for a scorched earth policy to save Ukraine. To save Ukraine, we're going to burn it to the ground, cause cancer, you know, like it's like,
yeah, that's
kind of infrastructure.
I'm glad you're saying that, because that's what it felt like to me, too, which is, so all of that eastern part of Ukraine that now Russia controls, which is the most fertile ground in the world, they're, you know, it's going to be totally contaminated, right? Just to put some context on this, if the UK, which talks about its green economy, right, not only will this destroy Ukraine with this depleted uranium, but it will also be polluted for generations to come. Yeah. Depleted uranium shells release a highly toxic powder upon impact. The radioactive dust then gets into the soil and the subsoil. This soil in eastern Ukraine, of course, is the most fertile in the world. We've talked about this extensively on the show. Even Colonel McGregor talked about how it was being literally dug up and shipped to parts of Europe because it's so fertile to being used during World War II. That's how fertile it is. And if this stuff gets in it, if this powder, this radioactive powder gets in it, game over. It also contaminates the clothes on your clothes, the skin of Ukrainian citizens when it gets hit. They then in turn can carry it to other people. It becomes a transport agent. They become a transport agent of...
Okay, now, if that's true, that's fucked up.
...which then transfers to any living thing it touches. Any person that comes in contact with it, it transfers to that person. If you wanted some context, more context, here's, you know, in Iraq, radioactive weapons, estimated 286 tons of depleted uranium munitions were fired...
I'd have to research that.
In Iraq and Kuwait,
this might be true. It could very well be true.
Used in the 2003 invasion. You can see the dust cloud there in the lower right-hand parts of your screen. So upon impact, it releases this secondary explosion where, you know, where the depleted uranium turns into like a powder.
If it's doing something where it's getting on people's clothes and then that is being transferred to non-combatants, then that's fucked up and that should be banned. 100%.
And look at those photos. Horrible photos.
I don't know if I care about a combatant getting cancer, though.
We're not going to show them here on the show.
Either side.
You can see what the United States did there.
Assuming the people using it know what it's going to do, I don't know if I care about the people having
soldiers, families of
who it's being used against, either side.
The Balkans. So many
because
it's called the Balkan syndrome. Look that up. Do some
again,
on that. If you're in England, you need to tell
get shot or get cancer. I don't know what.
If there's anyone left with a brain,
I say that with my dad having died from cancer. So like,
if that's not enough, the U.S.
I don't know. I just don't know which one's better or worse.
This morning, as part of this massive offensive, is now pressing the Biden administration. Four Republicans are signing a letter calling for cluster bombs to be sent to Ukraine.
Oh, these again?
Yeah. Remember, Ukraine was asking for these. Republican lawmakers pressed Biden to send cluster
bombs. Yeah, I don't
have
any problems with that, though.
And they signed a letter. Four leading Republicans in Congress sent a letter to Biden urging him to provide Ukraine with cluster bombs, which, of course, we will then be using. It's not like Ukrainians are going to use them. There's no one
left. Like-
okay, again, they are training the Ukrainians to use them. The U.S. is not literally using them, but if he wants to be hyperbolic, I'm fine with it, I guess.
Aren't those internationally illegal?
They are, but you'll know that Ukraine and the United States have not signed that illegal, that 2008 agreement. So the United States and Ukraine can
cluster
use
bombs.
Munitions that are carried out against civilians and kill civilians. So the United States is
not commission of cluster munitions is an international
Ukraine
treaty that prohibits all use, transfer, production,
and
stockpiling
well
of cluster bombs,
Russia
a type of explosive weapon
as well
which scatters submunition
so
bomblets over an area.
Without technically
okay.
being considered a war crime, since the United States will be...
Y'all see it, the thing, what is it, in like 20-30 minutes? Y'all see there.
Oh, no. Well, today, Politico ran a story saying, absolutely a quick study. Ukrainians master Patriot system faster than expected. So we are supposed to believe that they can read and train manuals in English, I guess, without our own participation. Like, we're...
Okay, a lot of countries of the world speak English already. A lot of them do. Like, a lot of Russians speak English. Like, tons of people speak English.
Just telling them, this is how you use it if you need a Zoom...
Also, it's, like, supposed to be super, super intuitive.
...tutorial, we're available, that, you know, sure, they can handle it. So, we are supposed to sort of have a hands-off, we can just send it to them. It's basically like a blender. So
that's just what I've heard about the Patriot and the Javelin system.
Yeah, we had a plan for how long it'll take you to train in our Patriot missile systems, but they exceeded our expectations. They were, like, weeks, they were done weeks ahead of time.
To be fair, they are highly motivated.
Yeah.
Like Scott Ritter has pointed out on the show, it takes a long-ass time to learn how to use Patriot missile systems.
No, they're a quick study. It's okay.
Apparently, you can take, like, a Skillshare class.
Sure.
Yeah, there's just... I mean, the way they set it up, there's just a single button in it that says fire. That's all you gotta do. You just go in, you hit the big red button, and done.
They have a parrot that does
so
that.
It's so easy.
You know, one of those, like, electronic...
Yeah, it's probably... It's like, we've got the missiles 101. You're gonna learn missiles, you're gonna learn perfect English, you're gonna, you know, lose your accent. Like, it's a full course on how to basically run this like an American, as an American.
Exactly.
Yeah.
They are Ukrainian. Wink, wink. Sure. No, Americans are pushing the buttons on these. Don't think for a second that these are Ukrainians doing this.
Here's a quote from the commanding general of the Army's Fire Center of Excellence.
Okay, now, there, he's saying U.S. is directly doing it. And that is dangerous and terrible rhetoric. That is really, really bad and dangerous stuff that he should not be saying. I'd almost even argue that, I don't know if it should be illegal. Well, I don't know. Because what if Russia uses that to say the UK or the US is doing this and then attacks us? But I guess then it's a liability thing. Like, I don't know. You can't shout fire in a crowded theater.
Brigadier General Shane Morgan.
I don't know.
The Ukrainian soldiers are impressive and absolutely a quick study, like a proud parent he is. Due to their extensive air defense knowledge and experience in a combat zone, it was easier, though it's never easy, for them to grasp the Patriot system. They are the best of the best in what they do. Just, like, I'm so proud of them. Like, you know, potty training my youngest. Like, she just really got it. It was so
okay,
easy.
Again, they're, like, super motivated to learn
it's
it, though.
So amazing. The amount, as Scott Ritter has talked about, the amount of support involved in Patriot systems, it's no small thing. It's not like you're just sending four guys out to handle these things. The amount of infrastructure and support that these things entail, this is propaganda being handed to you on a plate right now. So using cluster munitions,
it's
by
not
all accounts, would be war crime.
Illegal, and he is not affiliated with any official news station. Who? Sorry, who?
Because due to the harm they cause civilians, cluster bombs have been
Clayton.
Banned by
no,
over 100 countries.
Yeah.
Under that 2008 convention.
I don't know if I would
again,
believe
Russia,
that he's
Ukraine,
at fault for the one thing. Because,
So the only
oh, you're saying he's not
cluster bombs in this war.
It's not. Oh, okay. I see what you're saying.
Bartlett,
they've
been using petal mines, which are technically.
Yeah, but like, if you go to a crowded theater and you shout fire, and then that causes like other people to act, and then somebody gets trampled and dies, you're liable for that. Like, just because you have freedom of speech doesn't mean you can do that. You know what I mean? The Supreme Court's already decided that like decades ago. So let's say you have a big platform where you then he's just exercising freedom of speech. No, but I'm saying like the Supreme Court has already decided that you can't go into a crowded theater and shout fire and like, you know, when people like freak out and try and get out of there and somebody gets trampled to death and dies, you are liable for that. You are not like free to do that, essentially. Freedom of speech. Oh, okay, sorry, I misread that. So I don't know. It gets weird because what if I'm just saying hypothetically, if somebody, let's say Russia, let's say Putin somehow heard it and was like, oh hey, the US is attacking us, you know, now we can attack the US, I would think that he should be liable if he didn't have any actual direct information showing or proving that the US was doing that. It's just dangerous rhetoric is all.
War crime. They've been thrown, of course, in residential zones. So these are petal mines, these little things that look like leaves on the ground.
That's
and
all.
Kids pick them up. Because they're like, oh, what is this? Like a fun little thing. And they pick it up and they blow their leg off. Look how the size of these things. Size of a lighter, cigarette lighter. And they're mixed in with leaves on the ground. You can't tell the distance. You're walking your dog, boom. In residential zones. So, you know, it's unbelievable. So these four Republicans that signed this letter, these four piece of shit Republicans who signed this letter need to be held in account. If any of you are in their district, you need to raise hell with them. Please, write to these people. So here they are. I'm going to name names. These are the four people that are calling for us to use cluster munitions in Ukraine, basically against civilians. Here they are. Representative Michael McCaul, who we've called out on the show before. That guy's a nut. Michael McCaul, the chair
Wait,
of the
hold on. Who's he saying he's using these mines?
In Ukraine. They've been using petal mines, which are using cluster munition support involved in Patriot systems. It's no small thing. It's not like you're just sending four guys out to handle these things. The amount of infrastructure and support that these things entail, this is propaganda being handed to you on a plate right now. So using cluster munitions, by all accounts, would be war crimes because due to the harm they cause civilians, cluster bombs have been banned by over 100 countries under that 2008 convention on cluster munitions. But again, Russia, Ukraine, and the U.S. did not sign that treaty. So the only people that have been using cluster bombs in this war, like, oh, what is this? Like a fun little thing. The Bartlett has been Ukraine. They've been using petal mines, which are...
Okay, that's not true. That's a direct lie. Okay, so petal mines. PFM-1 was used during Soviet invasion of Afghanistan. Allegedly resulting in high number of casualties among children for being mistaken for a toy due to its shape and coloring. And then the Ukrainian government alleged that the Russian Federation deployed PFM-1 mines during 2022 Russian invasion of Ukraine in March 2022. Deutsche Welle found no evidence to support this accusation. In June, Human Rights Watch reported that Russia had used at least seven types of anti-personnel mines in at least four regions of Ukraine, but could not ascertain PFM-1 use in its briefing. But said in January 2023 that its team saw physical evidence of PMF anti-personnel mine use in seven of the nine areas around Izium and urged the Ukrainian government to investigate possible PMF use by its forces. Oh, wait. So physical evidence of PM anti-personnel mine use in seven of the nine areas around Izium and urged the Ukrainian government to investigate possible PMF use by its forces. By whose forces? In Russian-controlled Donetsk, many PFM-1 were dispersed widely, and Russian and local sources accused the Ukrainian army of being responsible for the deployment. I doubt that. I don't know about that one, because this was something that the Soviets were using. Now, technically, Ukraine was part of the Soviet army, but I don't know about that one. That sounds like Russia's doing to me. I don't know. High explosive of Soviet and Russian production. PFM-1, Russian, a bunch of stuff. Anti-infantry high-explosive mine is a scatterable, high-explosive, anti-personal landmine of Soviet and Russian production. I don't know on that one. I don't think Ukraine should be taking the blame on that one.
They've been thrown, of course, in residential zones. So these are pedal mines, these little things that look like... Thank you so much for watching this segment here.
Oh, too far.
Raise hell with them. Please. Right to these people. So here they are. I'm going to name names. These are the four people that are calling for us to use cluster munitions in Ukraine. Says a lighter.
Okay, that's all. I don't care if they use cluster munitions or not. I don't know. I'd have to think on it. I'd have to know more about it. All right, I gotta go. It's nice to talk to you, Mr. Gamertag. Also, sir, have you picked up that book? I'm not. I know I need to. Fuck, there was something else. Oh, my sister apparently edits some podcasts where they talk about like romance novels. I need to get that for you. She's in the Discord chat. It's a Weddle. The W3DDLE. You can message her. She apparently produces some romance novel podcast. But I really gotta go. You have a great day. I will talk to you later.